जय स्वामीनारायण स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द रिस्टार्ट इंस्ट्रक्शन पिन 8085। रिस्टार्ट इंस्ट्रक्शन इन 8085 द इंस्ट्रक्शन सेट हैज नेमोनिक that is RST small n, where n is equal to number starting from 0 and ending from 7. These 8 numbers are supported in the RST instructions. It starts from 0 and starts from end from n to 7. Okay, thus there is a 8 possibility occurs. How many possibility occurs? There is 8 possible RST instructions are there. Okay. Example tarike RST 0, RST 1, RST 2, RST 3, RST 4, RST 5, RST 6, and RST 7. Okay, it is functionally similar with RST n is equal to call n multiplied by 8. It is, what is the RST n? RST n is the similar with the call instruction, but the value given in the n, it is multiplied by 8. And kitla vade multiply karvama aave che? 8 vade multiply karvama aave che. Suppose I write here RST 4. So in the call, the 4 is multiplied by 8. 4 into 8 is a 32. Now this 32 is in the decimal. Is ema che? Decimal ma che. And all the instruction in the 8085 are converted into the hex code. So the value 32 is converted to hex, that is 0020H. This is the hex number. This is the hex number. So this RST4, it is equal to call 0020H. Okay. The advantage of RST2 is, RST instruction no advantage su che, to it has only 1 byte instruction. E kitla byte ni instruction che? 1 byte ni instruction che. Whereas the call instruction is of a 3 byte instruction. Okay. So to store the restart instruction, it requires only 1 byte. And kitla byte ni jarur pade che? Ikkaj byte ni jarur pade che. Jare call instruction che, the call ne apde, this call requires 3 byte. कितला बाइट ने जरूर पड़े छे? 3 बाइट ने जरूर पड़े छे. That's why it is used. Okay. Thus, RST instructions are useful for the branching to frequently used subroutine. Subroutine नी अंदर RST instruction नो उप्योग वधारे करवामा आवे छे. Why? Because the branching instruction usually used the call instruction. इसे नो उप्योग करे छे? Call instruction नो उप्योग करे छे. But the call instruction requires 3 byte. Call instruction ne kitla byte ni jarur pade chhe? 3 byte ni jarur pade chhe. Jyare apde, when we are using the restart instruction, it requires only 1 byte. Kitla byte ni jarur padse? 1 byte ni jarur pade chhe. Now we will see the mnemonics starts from RST0 to RST7. How many opcode? So it's opcode. Okay, so what is the target address? We will see the target address. के टार्गेट एड्रेस केटलू बनशे वेन इट इज आर एस टी जीरो द जीरो इज मल्टीप्लाइड बाय एट सो वॉट इज इट इट्स अ जीरो वॉट इज इट इट्स अ जीरो सो इट्स टार्गेट एड्रेस फ्रॉम वेयर द एग्जीक्यूशन ऑफ द इंस्ट्रक्शन स्टार्टेड इज 0000H. It is only 0, but in the hex code, the address required the 16 bit. So we have to write like this. When RST 1, so 1 is multiplied by 8. So it's a 8. Okay. So what is the hex of 8? It's a only 8. So we can write here 00008H. Then 2. So 2 is multiplied by 8. So it will be 16. કેટલા થશે 16 સો 2 ક્રોસ 8 16 વોટ ઇઝ ધ હેક્સ ઓફ 16 ધેટ ઇઝ 10 સો ઇટ વિલ બી 0010H ધેન 3 સો 3 ઇઝ મલ્ટીપ્લાઇડ બાય 8 ઇટ્સ અ 24 સો હિયર ઇઝ અ 0018H ધ હેક્સ ઓફ 24 ઇઝ અ 18 ધ હેક્સ ઓફ 24 ઇઝ અ 18 ધેન 4 ઇઝ મલ્ટીપ્લાઇડ બાય 8 ઇટ્સ અ 32 So 0 then 20H. Then 5. 5 is multiplied by 8. It's a 40. So 0028H. Then 6. 6 is multiplied by 8. It's a 48. So 0030H. Okay. RST 7. It's a 7 multiplied by 8. It's a 56. It's a 56. The hex of 56 is a 38. So 38. So when we are using the RST 0 instruction, it performs the call 0000H. When we are performing RST 1, it performs the call 0008H. When we are using RST 2, it uses 0010H. Okay. So this is the use of the RST instruction. RST instruction no upyog chhe. Okay. Now we will see the hex code. We will see the hex code given in the RST instruction. Suppose I have instruction RST 0. Its hex code, its opcode is C7. Kitlo opcode chhe? C7 chhe. So C7 is converted into the binary. That is 1 1 0 0 0 1 1 1. Then next is the RST1. The next is the RST1. So what is it opcode? It opcode is a CF. So CF is a 1 1 0 0. Then what is the hex of F? That is 1 1 1 1. F say F means 15. 15 binary. For time 1, then RST2, that is D7, that is D7. So what is the binary of D? 1101, 70111. Then RST3, that is DF. So it's a 1101111. Then RST4, that is E7. What is the binary of E? It's a 1110 and then 0111. Then RST5. It's a RST5 means EF. So 1110. 1111. Then RST6. That is F7. So 1111. Then 1101, and last is RST7. So it performs F. Okay, so it's a 1111111. Now in this table you can see that the most middle hex code. The 3 bits, the most middle 3 bits represent this number. So it's a 0. So you can see here. It's a 000. Here is a 1. So here is a 001. 2. So 010. 3. 011. 4. 100, 5 101, 6 110, 7 111. So it represent the operand hex code. Okay, so this is the use of the RST instruction. Let us consider for an example RST4 instruction. Okay, let us consider the one example, that is RST4. In the RST4, it is a 1 byte instruction. Kitli instruction say 1 byte instruction. Why RST instruction used? Because it uses the only 1 byte to store. એ સેનો ઉપયોગ કરે છે? ખાલી એક જ બાઇટ નો ઉપયોગ સ્ટોર કરવા માટે કરે છે. ધેટ્સ વાય ઇટ રિપ્લેસિસ ધ કોલ ઇન્સ્ટ્રક્શન. ઇટ રિપ્લેસિસ ધ કોલ ઇન્સ્ટ્રક્શન. ફંક્શનલી ઇટ ઇઝ 4 ઇઝ મલ્ટીપ્લાઇડ બાય 8. સો ઇટ્સ અ 32. ધ હેક્સ ઓફ ધ 32 ઇઝ 0028. સો ફંક્શનલી ઇટ ઇઝ સેમ એઝ કોલ 0028. Now we know that in the previous lecture we have studied whenever the call instruction is executed, jare pan call instruction execute thai che tyare shu thase, so the address of the next instruction, that is stored on the stack pointer, means push program counter. This program counter, what does it do? It does the value of the program counter that is given to top of the stack. Kya api devama aave chhe? Top of the stack ni andar api devama aave chhe. Okay, so whatever the contents, that is push into the PC and it jumps on the address. Which address? So JMP 0010H jumps on 0020H. This address is available at here. Okay, so this can be used. Now suppose I use RST5, so 5 is multiplied by 8, that is 40. The address of the 40 is a 0020H. So whenever it uses the, it jumps on the 0020H or 0028H. It jumps on 28H. So in this way the restart instruction is used. Why restart instruction is used? Because it occupies only the 1 byte of address, whereas the call instruction, it occupies the address or it occupies the space of 3 byte. કેટલા બાઇટ નું મેમરી સ્પેસ યુઝ કરે છે? તો એ 3 બાઇટ ની મેમરી સ્પેસ યુઝ કરે છે. Okay, so this is the requirement of RST instruction. From the today's lecture, you have to write 2 questions, and they are, the question number 1 is explain RST instruction. So લખવાનું છે, explain RST instruction. And second is why RST instruction replaces call instruction. Okay, so these are the different types of branch instructions we have studied. In the branch instruction, we have studied that the first jump instruction. In the jump instruction, we have studied the conditional jump and unconditional jump. Then we have studied call instruction. In the call instruction, we have studied conditional call and unconditional call. Third, we have studied about the return instruction, that is RET, and last we have studied about the restart instruction. These 4 instructions are known as a branch instructions. So in the exam, if you are asked that explain the branch instructions, so you have to explain all these 4 instruction with explanation or with example. Okay, so this is the call instruction you have studied or branch instruction you have study. Further, this is the completion of your unit number 3. Further, we will study the different types of interrupts in the unit number 5, that we will start in the next lecture. Jai Swaminarayan.